Oh my god! Do you know SpaceX is losing millions of dollars without launching Falcon 9 because of FAA? What exactly is happening? Hey, I'm Lucas. Welcome to the SpaceX community. Let's get started. Hello everyone, and welcome back. SpaceX still hasn't received approval from the FAA to resume their routine Falcon 9 launches. It's quite ironic when you compare this to the Boeing Starliner leak. While the Starliner leak seems to be a non-issue, SpaceX's second stage engine failure has turned into a major problem. Many of you might be wondering when SpaceX will finally start launching Falcon 9 again, and what exactly is going on between SpaceX and the FAA. Don't worry, we'll cover all of this in today's episode. SpaceX is currently seeking approval to resume launching its Falcon 9 rocket, while the investigation into the recent Starlink 9-3 anomaly continues. The Federal Aviation Administration, FAA, stated that SpaceX submitted a request for a public safety determination on July 15th. If approved, this determination would allow SpaceX to proceed with launches while the investigation remains open. The anomaly occurred during a Falcon 9 launch on July 11th, when the rocket's upper stage failed to complete its second burn due to a liquid oxygen leak. This failure prevented the rocket from circularizing its orbit before deploying 20 Starlink satellites, leaving them in a very low orbit with a perigee of just 135 kilometers. The high atmospheric drag at this altitude has prevented the satellites from raising their orbits using their electric propulsion systems. As a result, SpaceX announced that the satellites would re-enter Earth's atmosphere and burn up. Elon Musk, SpaceX's CEO, mentioned that satellite controllers attempted to maximize the electric thrusters to overcome the atmospheric drag, but acknowledged that it was unlikely to succeed. Despite the malfunction, the satellites pose no threat to other satellites or public safety due to their low orbit and design to disintegrate upon re-entry. By the way, Meat Fume, our today's sponsor. I was on the lookout for innovative products to share with you, and I recently discovered something really interesting in the world of flavored air. Say hello to Fume, an award-winning device that's taken things to the next level. Fume is a really cool device that's elevating the flavored air experience. This stylish and durable gadget is designed for on-the-go use, with no limitations, no vapor, no battery worries, and no nicotine. It's the perfect companion for any setting, whether you're relaxing at home or out and about. I've struggled with my fair share of habits I'd like to break. You know, those moments when you instinctively reach for something out of habit, especially in social situations. Fume has been a game changer for me in those moments. It provides a satisfying alternative to hold and use, with magnets and clicks that are surprisingly entertaining to play with, a great remedy for my old habits. And you know, Fume offers awesome flavors like crisp mint and orange vanilla, reminiscent of herbal teas. I tried crisp mint, and it's a refreshing change. With over 300,000 customers served, you can try it too. Use my code SpaceXCommunity to get a free Fume base with the Journey Pack for a limited time. Head to tryfume.com or scan the QR code to join the flavored air revolution. Back to the topic. Following the mishap, SpaceX has been transparent with the FAA and NASA about the incident and the ongoing investigation. The FAA has two options for allowing the Falcon 9 to resume flights: approving the final report of a SpaceX-led investigation that identifies corrective actions, or issuing a public safety determination if the mishap did not involve safety-critical systems or jeopardize public safety. If the FAA approves SpaceX's request, the company plans to launch the Starlink 10-4 and Starlink 10-9 missions from Florida later this week. However, SpaceX might have to wait until the investigation is fully completed before resuming launches. In the meantime, NASA has stated that it is receiving regular updates from SpaceX about the Falcon 9 rocket as part of its fleet monitoring. NASA emphasized the importance of crew safety and mission assurance, and expressed confidence in SpaceX's transparency and cooperation during the investigation. NASA will provide updates on any potential schedule impacts on agency missions as more information becomes available. The Starlink 9-3 anomaly underscores the complexities and challenges of space launches, even for experienced operators like SpaceX. The company has a robust track record of addressing and learning from such incidents, which is crucial for the continued development and deployment of its satellite constellation and other missions. SpaceX's pursuit to expand its Starlink constellation is part of a broader effort to provide global internet coverage, particularly in underserved and remote areas. Each launch typically deploys dozens of small satellites into low Earth orbit, creating a network capable of delivering high-speed internet to users worldwide. The recent anomaly, however, highlights the inherent risks and technical challenges involved in space operations. The Falcon 9's upper stage anomaly was a rare occurrence, but SpaceX has faced and overcome similar challenges in the past. The company's approach to handling these incidents involves thorough investigations, identifying root causes, and implementing corrective actions to prevent recurrence. This process not only enhances the reliability of their rockets, but also ensures the safety of subsequent missions. In the case of the Starlink 9-3 mission, the liquid oxygen leak that prevented the upper stage from completing its second burn was an unexpected setback. Liquid oxygen is a critical component of the rocket's fuel system, and any leak can significantly impact the mission's success. The leak led to the deployment of satellites into an elliptical orbit with a very low perigee, subjecting them to high atmospheric drag and preventing them from achieving their intended operational orbits. SpaceX's transparency in addressing the anomaly has been commendable. The company promptly shared details of the incident and its impact on the satellites. This openness helps build trust with regulatory authorities, partners, and the public. It also demonstrates SpaceX's commitment to safety and continuous improvement. The FAA's role in this situation is to ensure that any decision to allow the Falcon 9 to resume flights is based on comprehensive data and a thorough understanding of the anomaly's causes and implications. The agency's public safety determination process is designed to balance the need for continued space operations with the paramount importance of protecting public safety. If the FAA grants the public safety determination, it will signify that the agency is confident in SpaceX's ability to conduct future launches without jeopardizing safety. This determination would be a significant milestone, allowing SpaceX to proceed with its planned Starlink missions and potentially other launches. However, this approval would not signal the end of the investigation, but rather an interim measure allowing operations to continue under close scrutiny. The pending launches of Starlink 10-4 and Starlink 10-9 are critical for maintaining the momentum of SpaceX's satellite deployment strategy. Each launch incrementally builds the Starlink constellation, enhancing its coverage and capacity. Delays in these launches could impact the overall timeline for achieving global coverage and expanding service availability. In addition to the Starlink missions, SpaceX has several other high-profile launches on its schedule. These include missions for government and commercial customers, such as the Northrop Grumman Cygnus spacecraft, which delivers supplies to the International Space Station, and the Crew 9 astronaut flight, a part of NASA's Commercial Crew Program. The successful completion of these missions is vital for SpaceX's reputation and its partnerships with key stakeholders. The Falcon 9's reliability is a cornerstone of SpaceX's business model. The rocket has a strong track record of successful launches, and maintaining this reliability is crucial for customer confidence. The ongoing investigation into the Starlink 9-3 anomaly and the implementation of any necessary corrective actions will play a key role in preserving and enhancing this reliability. As the investigation progresses, I'm sure that SpaceX will continue to refine its processes and technologies to prevent similar incidents in the future. The company's ability to learn from its experiences and implement improvements is a testament to its resilience and commitment to innovation. Each challenge faced and overcome strengthens SpaceX's capabilities and reinforces its position as a leader in the aerospace industry. The upcoming weeks will be critical for SpaceX as it awaits the FAA's decision and prepares for the next series of launches. The outcome will not only determine the immediate future of the Falcon 9 rocket, but also influence the broader trajectory of SpaceX's ambitious plans for space exploration and satellite deployment. In summary, SpaceX is currently seeking FAA approval to resume Falcon 9 launches following the Starlink 9 to 3 anomaly. The incident, caused by a liquid oxygen leak, prevented the rocket's upper stage from completing its second burn, leaving the satellites in a low orbit with high atmospheric drag. Despite efforts to raise their orbits, the satellites will re-enter Earth's atmosphere and burn up. The FAA's decision on the public safety determination will determine whether SpaceX can proceed with its planned launches while the investigation continues. This period is pivotal for SpaceX, as it seeks to maintain its launch schedule and uphold its reputation for reliability and innovation in the aerospace industry. Thanks for watching today's episode. Don't forget to subscribe and give us a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. Stay tuned for another great video tomorrow.